La semaine dernière, l'indice S&P 500 a encore terminé à un niveau inédit. Il a dépassé de presque 7 points son record du 7 mai à 4239 points. La hausse des prix à la consommation s'est aussi accélérée à 5% sur un an. C'est le plus haut depuis 13 ans. Pour certains experts, c'est un nouveau signe du pic de l'inflation. Matthew Hornback, Global Head of Macro Strategy at Morgan Stanley, explains on CNBC.
I think the underlying dynamic that the global marketplace and the global economy has been dealing with for about a year now has been liquidity coming from central banks all over the world. Of course, the ECB and the Fed have been the two, you know, prominent players in the liquidity game, but the liquidity continues to flow. We can see that in a variety of ways, and I think what you saw yesterday was once we got past a pretty big risk event, which was the US CPI report, investors decided it was time to start putting that money to work. And that went into a variety of asset classes, including treasuries and equities, as you noted.
So let's talk about why interest rates are falling right now, Matt. I understand there are positioning aspects. There may be some technical aspects to that. But is there any fundamental reason why we could be shaking off a few months' worth now of hotter than expected inflation data and still having yields react the way that they are? What gives?
Yeah, Dom, I think what might be going on is the idea that when you're dealing with cost push inflation, you know, when companies or businesses are raising prices, despite a demand outlook from their perspective that just might not be that great, then you're really talking about potential for softer growth in the future. And that might be one of the things that's going on right now. In fact, earlier this week, the small business survey and the NFIB survey came out, and some of the data in there was a little concerning. We saw that small businesses were planning on raising prices pretty aggressively over the next 3 months, but their expectations for sales over this period were actually still pretty depressed, which is a bit odd, right? Why would you be raising prices when your expectations for sales aren't going up? Well, it's because your own costs are going up and you're forced to raise prices. So something like that, you know, is not great for the demand.
Et même si l'inflation inquiète, la Banque centrale européenne a maintenu son cap monétaire accommodant en fin de semaine dernière. Selon Christine Lagarde, la hausse de l'inflation en zone euro devrait passer à 1,9% contre 1,5% attendu. On resterait cependant en dessous de l'objectif des 2% fixé par la BCE. Même chose aux États-Unis où la Banque centrale américaine reste assez sereine. Former Fed Governor Sarah Bloom-Raskin retaliate and insist on inflation fears.
The Fed certainly does not seem to be super concerned, right? Because what we have seen is real price pressure, right? There's price pressure in terms of cars, particularly used cars. There's price pressure in terms of air travel. So there are particular areas that are really really pushing the inflation numbers up higher than anybody, I would say, expected. That said, you see the Fed really holding firm, really trying to see through this increase as purely transitory. Some of them are actually saying welcome, like they're happy to be seeing this this increase. So the Fed is looking through it and looking right past it. And right now, it appears as if markets are doing the same. As Steve pointed out, the 10-year treasuries did not react particularly strongly to the CPI news. And at the same time, you are seeing the Fed starting to talk about a little bit of movement away from the extraordinary measures that were put in place during the pandemic.
Et tout de suite, Cossé Labouèche vous présente Unexpected.